Okay guys, we are back with another video. This is episode 3 of the Italy Let's Play. Let's get straight into the game. Yesterday I invaded Yugoslavia and Egypt. And as you can see, Yugoslavia is basically off the map already. In an hour, they will change. A lot will revolt, but it seems like we have some pretty good morale in like at least half of the country. So some will revolt, but we are cleaning this up pretty well. So soon Yugoslavia will be fully gone. After that, I will probably take out Bulgaria, prepare a stronger army for the Balkans, and in the meantime take out Egypt, and then I can do, well, basically whatever I want. Now in Egypt we took some provinces over here, but we have been unable to take Luxor, unfortunately. So we're gonna move the port set with this militia, as it's still walking. And we also took this out with no damage, since like Egypt is inactive now. We took out another infantry in Marsa Matruh, so we can use this and send it to Alexandria, so we can take that city. With the units that we have here, I'm gonna walk straight through the north of the country, from Marsa Matruh to Alexandria, and then to Port Said and Cairo. Taking these four cities basically means we won the war. We also have like 200 health worth of units, so that's a good amount. So we should be able to take Egypt without a problem. We have 57 frontier ports, mostly captured a lot of stuff, built some units, research, and then all of that stuff. So we are doing pretty well. Luxor still not captured. We're gonna capture it last, it seems. Our economy also got a massive boost from taking Yugoslavia already, which is great. Research wise, well, we are doing great. Artillery is good, and I think just about everything is. I don't think we need to level up anything currently, especially with our limited budget. We got a lot over here, but we're gonna use that pretty quickly. So I'm gonna get level 3 mediums building. We already have level 2 tank plants in Naples. I'm gonna build level 2 in Rome as well, so we have enough medium tanks. And in Florence, I'm gonna... Well, in 1 minute this is done. Let's schedule level 4 industry in Florence. That's gonna cost a nice bit. Rare materials is doing great, but we can definitely build some more industry in Bologna, so we get more metal production. I'm actually gonna wait for that. We have level 2 here, and we got built some units, so that's pretty good. Looking now, we have 67. They are pretty good level and all of that. So 3500 is being spent per day on units. That's pretty good currently. We're gonna want to make that a lot higher, but for now it's great. So I think Egypt will fall pretty soon. We should be able to take all of it in about 24 hours or something like that, maybe a little more. But yeah, should be easy to do. There goes the industry, so let's build Bologna up to level 4. So we actually have even more metal and oil as we are building Florence up too. As you can see, it's costing, but it's fine. So in these two areas, well, this is still building, but in Naples, I'm gonna build a median tank. Level 2, that's 13 hours, that's fine. Let's also schedule one here. In these two, we're gonna... Well, actually, no. In Perugia, I'm gonna keep building motorized. I'm gonna need another one for motorized, though. And that can be... Well, Florence is looking decent, but we are building industry there and all of that, so... not really worth it. We already have, like, four places for ordnance, so I'm gonna make... Let's say Milan is gonna be building motorized. So there we go. And the rest can go to ordnance. Artillery, really. There we go, that's production, even better than yesterday. Now it's 7 units. And thing is, these are good units, so yeah. Production center is being expanded, so is industry, and that's all good and stuff. Our economy is actually looking pretty good at this point, surprisingly enough. So we are building everything, units, industry, production centers, we are still invading Egypt, Yugoslavia is being taken out. What else do we really have? Well, I think we've done just about all we need to. We can prepare to invade Bulgaria next, but yeah, we're still taking care of Yugo, so not yet. And I think all is looking good in general. So Egypt is gonna be a victory by tomorrow, I'm sure of it. Yugoslavia is gonna be gone within a couple of hours. Then I can take out Bulgaria tomorrow, prepare for Greece maybe, and generally upgrade the army and make it stronger and better. The units we already built yesterday, which is all of this stuff, the artillery, the median tank, and all that can go to the Balkans, as we're definitely gonna need a lot more units there. I think that's pretty clear. So there we go, that's gonna be some reinforcements in the Balkans. We're gonna be upgrading those units too. I want to take Bulgaria so I can cut off Romania from the rest of the Balkans. That should be pretty possible. If I do that, well, I have a lot of strength. They don't have that much, not as much as me. And if I take Greece, well, there's another big economic boost. Same with Egypt. We already have 3,900 per hour. With all of Egypt, I'm gonna be making like 4,500 by tomorrow. Taking Bulgaria would mean like 5,000 because of more morale. And with Greece, well, let's not even talk how much that would be. We'd be talking, you know, we're already a big, or basically a massive European power, especially here in the Balkans. So yeah, though, everything is looking great. Invading Egypt, we are winning. Yugoslavia is gone, and the plan is clear. Production is great, and so is everything else. Economy looking great. So that's about it. I think I'm gonna end it already. So thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. You can like and subscribe and all that if you want. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Goodbye.